an exhibition was going to be held in Ankit and Pavan's school. Both decided to take part in it together. They had to show an experiment related to air. Pavan has come to Ankit's place to discuss about the project.
Pavan, come sit. I will get some water for you.
No, Ankit, you also sit. Ankit, this time we will show such an experiment with air that will amaze everyone.
Of course, but Pavan, nothing has crossed my mind regarding this. What experiment are we going to do related to air?
That's what we are going to discuss today.
Okay, so can we show that air expands on heating and contracts on cooling? For example, if we blow up a balloon, tie it tightly and put it into the fridge, then it will contract in a few hours. And if we put into the sunlight, it will expand again and will regain its size. The expansion and contraction of the balloon shows the expansion and contraction of the air.
Wow, that's a great idea.
But it's a bit short experiment and easy too. We need to make something else with this.
We can show that air contains lot of dust particles as well.
Ankit, our teacher herself has shown this to us. One could see small shiny particles of air through the sunlight passing from the window.
Yeah, I do remember. Alright, I am thinking that we can prove what are the components of the air.
Yes, it seems to be fun. Let's discuss this topic.
See, if we take out a water bottle from the fridge and keep it outside, a layer of water forms on the outer surface of the bottle, even when the bottle is closed. Hence, it proves that molecules of water vapors are present in the air. It is this water vapor which causes rain.
Pavan brings an empty glass from the kitchen.
Ankit, do one thing.
Cover your mouth and nose in such a way that it covers your whole mouth.
And put this cloth on your uncovered part.
Now breathe as fast as you can.
After a while, Ankit starts struggling with his breath. He takes off the glass from his mouth.
Pavan, I was suffocating.
Ankit, you were suffocating because we inhale air in the form of oxygen. As there was limited oxygen in the glass, when all the oxygen present in it was consumed by you, you have started suffocating. This is because as the glass still have some amount of air in it, but all the oxygen in it has been consumed by you and its space has been taken by the carbon dioxide exhaled by you.
Probably, this is the reason that we like to breathe in a place with clear and clean environment, as the availability of oxygen is facile over there. Though, I have read that oxygen is the second most abundant gas present in the atmosphere. Nitrogen, which is most abundant gas present in the air, is a stable gas and does not react easily with other substances, and that's why its quantity is high and stable in the atmosphere.
You got it right. We also suffocate where air pollution is high or where something burns.
Because many toxic substances also enter our body with the air.
Why don't we try this as an experiment?
I know what to do. Wait, I will be back in a minute.
Ankit runs and brings a plate, a candle, and both start doing the experiment. Ankit lights up the candle in the plate. Pavan slowly pours water in the plate and fills it to the half. Now Ankit covers the candle with a glass. The candlelight starts to flicker and extinguishes after a while.
See, the water level has risen up in the glass. It means that the space created by the burning of oxygen was taken up by water.
And see, fumes have also filled the glass. It is probably a mixture of carbon dioxide and toxic gases.
What an interesting experiment it was. Have you seen that whenever we burn wood, it gives black fumes? That fume is a mixture of many gases, of which CO2 is the main component.
Yes, I heard in TV news that the pollution level of cities like Delhi, Lucknow often risen up, in which carbon dioxide is the main component due to which people struggle to breathe and can only see up to short distances. In winters, fog limits the visibility even more because of this.
Absolutely correct. When we travel up towards the sky, the quantity of oxygen and air decreases with height, due to which breathing is tougher on high mountains.
Okay, now we have had enough discussion on the composition of air. Now we should focus on our science exhibition.
Why don't we burn a plank of wood or camphor used in prayers instead of candles and use some chemicals instead of water, which could change the color of fumes on getting mixed with carbon dioxide?
Wow, Pavan, brilliant idea. Our experiment will be the best one. We should take our teacher's help for this.
Of course. Maybe this experiment was performed by many students, but with a few changes, we could make this pretty much competitive for the exhibition.
Pavan, enough of studies. Let's put the things we have gathered on their places and go to play.